Ladies and gentlemen, that was your main event of the evening, and normally we would all be making our ways to our cars, but not tonight. We've still got a huge announcement that is going to rock the foundation of alternative pro wrestling. But first, let me welcome a man out here who wasn't supposed to be here tonight, a man who was suspended by your APW commissioner, Kevin Pierce, and a man who wants to say a few words to get a few things off his chest. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Lethal Dose, Stryknyn!
Everyone, if you could bear with me, this is a little bit different than what everyone's come to expect, but kind of need to take a moment to talk to everyone a little bit more on a human level than normal, if that's okay. So I don't want to bore everyone too much with history, but Spring Break Bash 2013, that was in the main event, tagging with Jeremy Vane against Jacob Ashworth and Jacoby Boykins. In that match, I suffered a massive concussion, got knocked out, and APW's medical staff backstage, when they woke me up, I realized I couldn't see out of my right eye. That Monday morning, I had a meeting at Emory Medical Clinic with a man named John Thomas, and he told me that I had a 2/3 retinal detachment on my right side. Spare all the medical mumbo jumbo, but the inside lining of my eye came off. May 1st, I went under the knife at, again, Emory Medical Facility in Atlanta, Georgia. The short version was they had to take my eye out of my head, put the insides back together, and I spent several months away from the fans. I was got a lot of money coming in. And then the bills started showing up. And given the procedure that was done to me, it was in the six-figure range, and that's really steep. It's one of those things where you look at a piece of paper and your stomach drops. Because I'm on a level with everyone. I mean, the reality is that I got a house to pay for and kids to feed, like everybody else in this room. And usually, I don't want to delve too much into all the backstage stuff. Usually how it works in the independents is your injuries are your own responsibility. But given that I have been here for so long and shed a lot of sweat and blood in this ring, and I'm to understand I made a lot of money for alternative pro wrestling, then there were several meetings that had to do with the APW board and Emory's financial advisements, and they came up and leveled with a deal so that as long as I was employed by this company, they were going to fit the medical bill so I'd be able to keep the lights on and keep the kids fed. So fast forward to 2014, about 5 weeks ago, my contract was set to expire with Alternative Pro Wrestling as a talent on the active roster here. And the unfortunate reality is I had to do something that I really didn't want to do because the only position I was offered was by Kevin Pierce working for him directly. There comes a time, every now and then, when you have to do what you don't want to do, Because it's what you have to do. Because every now and then comes time in a man's life where you have to swallow every bit of pride you've ever amassed, swallow that knot in your throat, and sign the dotted line. Because at the end of the day, you gotta keep a roof over people's heads. So I signed Pierce's deal, and every week by week, Kevin Pierce has enjoyed way more than he should and way more than I care to really think about. Week by week, he's ripped away every shred of dignity that I've had as a man, as a person. It's been hard, but I've had to do what I've had to do to keep the boat afloat, despite the fact that every week after I leave here and I go home, I can't look at myself in the mirror, and I gotta do what I've gotta do to keep everything in line. And I keep wondering when it's gonna come to the point where I just can't do it anymore.
I don't think you're gonna have to do it anymore, Street. I can't take this anymore. So I think I've got something that's gonna make you feel just a little bit better. I've talked about this announcement since last night.
Single-handedly in this room. that just upsets you, doesn't it? That just makes you mad, doesn't it? You know what? You seem kind of upset right now. Is it just me or does he seem upset? He seems upset. Well, you know what, Stryknyn? I'm gonna give that anger somewhere to go. I tell you what, you're sitting in a steel chair right now, aren't you? Why don't you do me a favor? Why don't you fold that chair up and bend it over my skull? Come on! You pick that chair up and you blast me in the face! I dare you! Because you know what's good for you. Or do I have to call your little girl and see if she's got the guts to do it? I guarantee you, you take one clean shot with that chair and your kids will be swept up by defects just like that. You can't do it, kid! Just like I thought, you are just as pathetic as every single one of these people. You are just as weak, just as feeble-minded as they are. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you your broken hero, Stryknyn.
Are you finished? Is this enough? Are you done? I just want to make sure you're finished.
I'm absolutely finished. You got something you want to say? I've already spoiled your big announcement.
Actually, you didn't spoil my big announcement. My announcement is, yeah, this man has got a contract on the table that I've got signed exclusively from the board of directors for APW that he could sign. It would make him a talent for this company again. It would be the same contract he had before with a 10% increase in pay. But hang on, there's a catch. In order to get that contract, you would have to defeat this man at Freedom Fight 2014.
No. That's not how this works. You don't make the decisions. Shut! You don't make the decisions around here. I do. I've already beaten him once. Why do I have to do it again? I'm not doing it. Negative.
Actually, you are doing it. You boasted about your undefeated streak as a wrestler. Granted, that was only one match, and you did defeat the Lethal Dose Stryknyn, but if you had read the paperwork and the fine print on the contract you signed for that match, it obligates you for further matches during your contracted time with this company. So yes, you will do it one-on-one with Stryknyn on Friday, July the 18th. And if this man wins, he's back, brother.
You know what? Give me a second.
No, hang on. Actually, you don't have time for a phone call, because I'm not finished. After the hell you put this man and his family through, if at Freedom Fight he's able to do what he needs to do and kick your ass, not only will he be contracted as a talent, but you will no longer be the commissioner of APW. But hang on, there is one more catch. If by some
chance... I'm done listening to you! You shut up right now! You know what? You give me 2 seconds. You give me 2 seconds.
Hang on.
I tell you what. That's why it's good to be me, because you've always got a plan B. You want the match? You got it, but there's a twist, you see. Just like everything is on me, we're gonna even this out. You see, I know you wanna punch me and you can't do it, but come Freedom Fight, I'm gonna get my hands on you. But when I win that match, your contract belongs to me, and there's nothing you or the office can do about it. You are under my control. No questions asked when I beat you. So, you two gentlemen, you think about your game plan, and I will think about mine.
The best part, that match is going to be in a 15-foot high steel cage. Have a good night, Mr. Pierce.